Auburn from 2005 to 2006. What led you to be at Auburn in the first place?
Was recruited by Greg Knox at the time. Was the receivers coach, and came and got me out of Jefferson High School down to Tampa. And at the time, my grades went well in high school, and Coach Knox was there. Only one in my corner that was pulling for me and making sure I did what I had to do to get to Auburn. He sent me to junior college, and I showed my loyalty and appreciation for him sticking with me all through high school, and I did what I had to do in junior college and got back to Auburn. Got to Auburn, and that was my journey ever since.
Yeah, so many. Auburn has had some great luck with junior college transfers. Talk a little bit about that experience of not making it in at the beginning, having to go to junior college, but really sticking it out. What were those 2 years like, at junior college?
Definitely a learning experience for me. Just playing football, period. I didn't really play as much in high school, obviously because of my grades. But playing at junior college is definitely a learning experience just as a receiver, learning how to be a receiver. And, learning how to compete on that level, straight coming from high school, competing on the collegiate level against a lot of talented guys that's in the same position I'm in. That was a great experience. And also just knowing to be responsible and accountable academically. It definitely prepared me for Division I.
Well, talk a little bit about your time at Auburn. You made some pretty big catches in your career at Auburn.
Yes, I was, blessed to, be at Auburn and make big plays when we needed them. I just, took advantage of every opportunity that was given. And, it's definitely, like I said, it's a blessing, just to go out there and, play under the lights in front of thousands of fans. And, I just made sure, the opportunity comes my way, I had to make it. And, our coaches are so hard on us, we were accountable for everything we did. So they teach us that, real heavy. When I was there, and when opportunities come, we got to make the best of
it. You referenced the coaching staff there. Obviously, Tommy Tuberville was the head coach there at the time. Talk a little bit about him and how he helped your career.
Oh yeah, Tommy Tuberville, great guy, man. He mentored us, through the whole time I was there. He expected great things out of us. He's very inspirational and teach us things that, we needed to hear as far as, being away from home. And, he showed tremendous leadership, through our ups and downs and his expectation level for us, at the time that I was there, it was so high that, we made sure we met those expectations. And that's what was pretty fairly, good the years I was there. And, we expected, better things out of ourselves. So, Tom Tuberville was, definitely an inspirational person in my life.
Well, let me take you back to 2006, the Iron Bowl in Tuscaloosa, game coming down to the wire, 22-yard game-winning touchdown reception from Brandon Cox to Perche Rodriguez. Do you remember that moment?
Oh, absolutely. I'll never forget that moment.
Talk a little bit about that. Tell us about that play, about that game, and what that meant.
Well, just coming into that game, it was my second year playing in that game, and, down in Tuscaloosa, and, just the atmosphere was just electrifying. I couldn't believe my eyes, and just was trying my best not to get caught up into the, the hype and, just the atmosphere of the game, and, just go out there and play your game. And, it came down to, defining a moment in my career, just confidence-wise, and knowing that I knew this game was going to come down to the wire. Just in the history of all the Iron Bowls, they always come down to the wire. They're always, really, really tight games. And my coach always told me, stay ready because you never know. You could be that guy that, makes that play to help us win a game. And I always took that to heart. And, that time came. I was in the huddle, and, the play came, and, the call was to me, and I knew it was going to come to me at that time and moment, and we needed to play for me. So, in my mind, I'm like, coming out of the huddle and lining up, I was like, I got to make this play. So, the play went on, and I was in my route, and, I made sure I ran my best route. I made sure I was at my depth. And, after that, the ball's in the air. I'm competing to get that ball and bringing it down, and, it so happened to be a touchdown. And, man, it was just something that just propelled me to bigger heights of, you know, as far as my confidence goes. And that play right there just defined my entire football career.
Yeah, that Auburn goes 11-2 that year. I believe that was the fifth year in a row Auburn beat Alabama, goes on to beat Nebraska in the Cotton Bowl. A tremendous season for Auburn. Prashay, you went on after leaving Auburn and played in the Canadian Football League. Just talk about that a little bit.
Oh, man, yeah, that was definitely, again, a blessing to, you know, go up in Canada and play in the CFL. My rookie year, I was able to accomplish on winning the Eastern Division Rookie of the Year. And, you know, went out there just trying to prove a point, still am proving a point that I'm a really, you know, talented receiver, and, you know, I work hard and, you know, trying to reach my ultimate goal, and that is to get into the NFL, and I won't stop till I get there. And when I get in the NFL, I'm, you know, sky's still the limit. But, you know, just experiencing that up there in Canada in a whole other country, and, you know, I never thought I'd be up there. So that was absolutely just a gift. And, you know, learning the rules of the game, the dynamics of the game, you know, catching on. It took me a little bit to catch on, because I started out on the practice squad for the first 4 weeks, and, you know, they let me, you know, work my way up, and I finally got a hang of it. And, like, as soon as they activated me, I never looked back. And did 4 years up there and enjoyed my time, and now I'm playing to win the football every season.
Yeah, I can imagine. I bet that would be an interesting, you know, there are some significant differences, I guess. You know, what, talk about it, you know, I guess football is football, but, you know, what are some of the intricacies that you had to kind of get used to up in Canada?
Well, first of all, you know, the size of the field is way larger than the field we play on in college and high school and in the NFL. From sideline to sideline, I think it's like 50 or 62 yards. And from end zone to end zone is 120 yards. So it's a really massive field. And, you know, they teach us as receivers how to use that field, you know. And one of the interesting things that came to me as far as lining up as a receiver was there's no such thing as a legal procedure. So you can move around at the during the cadence of a quarterback calling the cadence out. You can move around at the line of scrimmage. You don't have to stay still. And I had to learn how to do that as far as, you know, they call it a downhill waggle or a motion, motioning down into the defense. You can, you know, start on one side of the field during the cadence and end up looping around and going to the other side within the cadence and setting up your route. And I had to learn how to, you know, use my motion to set up my release and, you know, run my route after I leave the line of scrimmage. That was another challenge, you know, learning what my depth was after I left the line of scrimmage, running full speed, you know, instead of being used to standing still, then running my route and being at my depth. So that was a challenge. And just the rules, you know, there's no such thing as touchbacks. The football is bigger, and it's only three downs. So, you know, it's a really big play league because of the amount of downs that you have. So it's a pretty, really fun league to play in.
When you referenced it earlier, you now are in the Arena Football League. How did that transition come about, going from CFL to the AFL?
Yeah, oh, a huge transition. You know, going from the biggest field to the smallest field. That was a big time transition. And you know, just growing up, since I was a kid, I was, you know, someone that loves challenges and loves to, you know, prove to myself, can I be the best? And I always, you know, wanted to do that on any level and anything I did. And you know, another challenge approached, and that was Arena Football, which is here now. And how can I be the best in this league? And so I watched guys, you know, that's in front of me. I watched guys that are really good in this league, and learning how to, again, run my routes, because you can't run your routes like you do in outdoors and indoors. There's totally different ways to run your routes in indoor, because you have this wall that's around you on a 50-yard field, and I think it's 50 yards long, and it's 32 yards wide, I believe. So it's really small, but so you got to find ways on how to, you know, get yourself open, create separation, and learning the dynamics of the game and angles of the game, because it's totally different from outdoors. And again, you get the motion in indoor as well, and just for playing in Canada, that helped me to, learn how to run my routes indoor. So that's why as soon as I hit the ground running in indoor, I just took off.
Well, you made pretty on YouTube here recently. You made a pretty spectacular catch, and then handed the touchdown ball to an Auburn fan in the stands. Tell us a little bit about that.
Oh wow! Yeah, like, I spotted the kids in the stands before that play even happened. I was like, man, when I score a touchdown, I'm giving the ball to those guys because I haven't seen any Auburn fans in a while, and that just just enlightened my soul. I was just so happy to see some Auburn fans in the stands, and then how close they were. It just worked out perfectly. So I ended up scoring a touchdown, and I ran over to him to make sure that he got that ball from a former Auburn wideout. And I was just excited to make them happy, and told them War Eagle and everything. And we took pictures after the game and everything. It's just good to see the family, the all-in family.
That's great. What's next for Perche Rodriguez?
Well, I'm still on my journey trying to get into the NFL. My agent is telling me teams are interested. Just keep working hard, and that's what I'm doing, working hard. One more last year, my contract with the team I'm with now. So hopefully there is an opportunity after this season to get into the NFL and continue my career. But, right now with the Pittsburgh Power, with the team I'm with, we're on a roll right now. We are actually sitting at 13-3 on a bye week as we speak. But I have to get ready for the playoffs and hopefully get this championship back to Pittsburgh.
Well, definitely. I know all Auburn fans out there are definitely Pittsburgh fans. Perche, we can't thank you enough for being a part of Sports Call this afternoon. Wish you all continued success, and hopefully you'll realize your dream very soon of being a receiver in the NFL.
Oh, thank you so much. I greatly appreciate that, guys. Thank you for being on the show. God bless you all.
Thank you very much.